Ultimate on both VG Bootcamp and Mad Fan Gaming. But we're right now getting into the match right here. Palka and DM, the Pikachu and the Snake versus Koopa Kev and Ember, the Rob and the Young Link. This is just, Palka is one of the better Snakes I know, and DM is also just such an incredible Pikachu player, both some of New England's best. So right now, Koopa Kev and Ember just gotta do so. Wow, that spin to win already. Not the full count. Oh my.
Was that an up air there?
I don't,
up air state spike?
Literally wasn't even looking in that direction.
That's the thing about doubles, man. So easy to miss some stuff sometimes.
So this is what I love actually about Snake in doubles. Snake's, like we were talking about before, but just the grenades and the bombs and everything that Snake had can change the way that you move around a battlefield in this game. It's just like, you could control one side of the stage, but all it takes is one little landmine, and you're like, okay, I'm not getting near that.
That's true, yeah.
Like, it really makes you think, because you just can't go running and gunning with a Snake on stage.
Right, you gotta be cognizant of everything, but Rob actually running out of his fuel there. Not able to make it with that upbeat.
And right now, Palka and DM is taking firm control of this game right now. And it's hard to say what they gotta do, because, well, Palka, there goes Palka's first stock. But Koopa Kev and Ember just are having a lot of trouble right now, just trying to take any stage control whatsoever. There's the first stock going for DM also, going off of the Young Link right there. But right now, you gotta think, what do Ember and Koopa Kev have to do to take stage control? They're trying almost everything, doesn't even matter, because there goes one of the stock changes, and we're down to one stock apiece for red team.
Goodness, when you get a good Snake on the field, They can take control of the stage basically however they want to.
Absolutely. Like, this is all a matter of, like, the Snake has to know how to space out his own projectiles and play safe.
That's right.
And his partner has to realize that as well. His partner now basically has a third opponent he has to watch because there's the danger of his partner actually killing himself in the process.
That is true.
And you still have that with every doubles team. You have to make sure you're watching your partner constantly, but now you not only are you having to watch your partner, you're having to watch your projectile use all over the place. And that Nikito is, before it was touched, tiny bit, Nikito was the best projectile in the game.
I can see it.
I believe that in a heartbeat. I was, I will always remember MVD telling me how at the E3 presentation, we basically watched, he basically got hands on Snake for a little bit, and the Nintendo people came over and he goes, so what do you think? Like, any like, feedback or anything? And he just looks at them and goes, nerf Nikita. And he plays Snake and he's like, no, this move's dumb. Change it. And
you know
guess what?
That's a man of integrity.
They didn't for a little while. And MVD won the first event. He won Dump Park on the Grass.
I mean, so sometimes some feedback.
Snake is a really good character if played correctly.
That is very true.
It's why these people like Palka or MVD can just like, or Ally can just play super well with this character who people originally was like, nah, nothing special.
Right.
Like, this character is a legitimate threat. And Pika also, a lot of people thought Pichu was like the better of the two. I think that's a common misconception at times now.
I think so?
I think Pika is better. I think everyone just gets caught up in the fact that Pichu is so much smaller. But I think it's just the more kill power with Pika.
That is true. You know what? With these nerfs now, you might be a little more correct.
I think before the nerfs even, I thought Pika was better. But now I think rest assured, I think Pika's better now. Hmm. I think Pika was better before the nerfs. But that's my hot take of the day. I'm just saying. But we're hopping back in. We're actually seeing a character switch. One character that you, Nintendo, really do take a liking
Let's
to.
Let's get it. Ganondorf. I'm excited to...
Wow. Do you take a leg to him now?
Oh! That was actually really smart, doing the upbeat, trying to save the Ganondorf. Doing it again! That is so smart! And still coming... Oh. They came back for a sec... You know what? I still really appreciate that team play
no,
there.
No, it's good. That's good right there. The fact that you have the and there's an SD from DM right there, but the fact that you can actually realize that your partner's in trouble and you need to go out and save them, and forget what you're doing for the time being, that's good teamwork right there.
Most definitely, yeah. And like, you don't see that all the time.
No. A lot of times, doubles can turn into that 1v1 if you're not experienced enough, but you got to realize when your partner's in trouble and you got to know when to be able to help each other out. Most of the time, you want to do it a little later, but that was still a good job to save his partner right there. But right now, the Ganon's in a little more trouble, and the Rob not able to get out in time. The Ganon down to his last stock.
The upper spike right there again by the Pika.
And now both red team are down to their last stock. Pelka hasn't lost a single stock yet. That's commentator's curse for you.
Way to go.
It's a thing, dude. It's a thing. Everyone's like, no, it's not a thing. It's a thing. I'm telling you. Forward throw coming out, or forward air, sorry. DM trying to drag down, try and go for that down air, trying to spike him and end Ganon right here. Ganon at 106. Dash attack coming out from Pelka. Landmine planted towards the right side, already exploded. Just constant damage output coming out. That's gonna cut both of them.
Not quite killing the Rob though. Still living barely. Nikita going out. Barely missing. Have to dodge a lot of bullets there just to get back.
And that's going to be up.
Yep, and that was just some solid play.
Absolutely, dude. Pelka and DM are two of New England's best. And it's the same thing with 6WX and Uno. It's the same thing with Beast and Juice. They are both respective players, and they're all respective players in their regions. And if they can be respective on their own, you can be damn well sure that they're going to be respected as a team.